Hi, and welcome to Parkinson's Disease Education. When most people think of Parkinson's disease, they think of things like posture problems, tremors, shuffling, slow gait, things like that. But as you'll find out in this video, there's a lot more to Parkinson's disease than meets the eye. Today, we're talking about myth bust number two, which is that Parkinson's disease is only a movement disorder. Be sure to stick till the end of the video to look for a secret message from me. So without further ado, let's start the credits and get this show on the road. Hit it. All right, so probably some of you have already guessed why this statement is a myth, the statement that Parkinson's disease is only a movement disorder. Obviously, those of you living with the disease process know that this is not true, but I want to highlight why this isn't true. As you know, most of the things that people typically associate with Parkinson's, as we talked about in the opening of the video, are more of the motor symptoms, the things you see on the outside. There are, in fact, multiple non-motor symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is, in and of itself, a central nervous system disorder, and so therefore it has effects on multiple organ and body systems, not just those that help us to move. So what other non-motor symptoms are there? There's a large crap ton of non-motor symptoms, but we're going to go over some of the most common ones today and those that you can look up, and also other videos to reference that I've covered on some of these topics in the past. So some of the most common problems you'll hear about are things like constipation, sudden drops in blood pressure. That's called orthostatic hypotension. There are also problems that you can experience with cognition changes, mood changes, behavioral changes. In addition to that, you can have issues with swallowing, lower speech volume, difficulty being understood, hoarse, gravelly voice. You can also have what they call mixed motor and non-motor symptoms, which kind of, with the speech language system, you can have that. So you will have issues with excess saliva, or perhaps dry mouth. You can also have dry eyes that can go along with that as well. There's issues with temperature regulation, sexual function. So just know, if you learn nothing else from this video, it's absolutely false that Parkinson's disease is only a movement disorder. It literally affects just about every facet of a person's life. And don't forget that, please.
Imagine it's a beautiful day outside. You want to go for a walk or maybe a jog, but you become so overwhelmed with fatigue. You get your shoes on, you tie them, and then you just can't get started because you can't bear the thought of doing anything.
Imagine what it would be like with cognitive problems that can affect attention, multitasking, planning, and all that, and trying to take a road trip, like a long road trip. Imagine, what would you pack? What route would you take to get there? What arrangements would you need to make to arrange for lodging, for example? All those things involve planning, multitasking, and forethought, and that's a really big struggle for people with Parkinson's disease over time. Not to mention, between you and me, some folks really need to turn in the keys eventually, and judgment over time is not always the best with PD either. Imagine you're the man in the relationship and you like to have an intimate evening with your loved one, but you have Parkinson's disease, so you might have erectile dysfunction. Or imagine you're the woman in the relationship, you may just have decreased or no sex drive whatsoever because of the Parkinson's. Just imagine if you were the one that had to hear that Parkinson's disease is only a movement disorder. Have compassion on people with Parkinson's disease that you know, or that are in your community, even if they're strangers, because you don't know the struggles that they're going through inside and out. For all those with Parkinson's disease who I've been blessed to have had touch my life, or even if you're just a stranger watching this video for the first time and you aren't connected with me directly, I want you to know that I have compassion for you and the entire Parkinson's community, and I want you to know that you are seen and you are heard, if not by anybody else, at least by me. But that's why this video exists, so that other people can learn about it and you can learn about it as well, to be able to articulate it to other people that you know in your life that need to know this information. That's about it for this video. Really appreciate you watching. Look forward to seeing you in another episode of Parkinson's Myth Bust. And I greatly look forward to making a video. I'm having fun doing this series, and I hope you're enjoying watching them as much as I'm enjoying making them. Love you all. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.